Se mai vine anche a me.
Thank you.
Please rise. Stay there a minute, stay there. Doug, come forward. Who presents this bride for marriage?
Mother and I.
Let me give the bride a kiss. I know you'll all get very upset with me if I don't tell you the bride and groom have requested that you be seated. Thank you, sir. Turn and face each other. I'm going to come slightly that way, just a tad. The line is in the middle. Whoop, that's perfect. Before I begin my service, I would just like to take up a few moments of your time and welcome you all here to the Chateau Alain. On behalf of Doug and Tara, I would like to extend a greeting from both of them to all of you. It's a greeting that's gone out from the shores of my country for thousands of years. And that greeting is a Cade Mila Falta. It's Gaelic, and it means 100,000 welcomes. It's meant for every single one of you. And to both of you, I'd like to say, Gura Mila Margot, which is also Gaelic, and it means thank you very much. Thank you very much for allowing me the pleasure, the privilege, the honor of doing your service here today. So, how are you feeling? That's what I want to hear. Feel better in about 20 minutes when I can buy you a drink, right?
Exactly. Exactly.
Dearly beloved family and friends, we have come here today to witness the joining in marriage of Doug and Tara. This ceremony is merely to solemnize or legalize the true marriage, which in reality took place when you made your commitment to each other before coming together for this ceremony. Certainly you are aware of the seriousness of your decision and of the responsibility that you are assuming. You are entering into a union that is most sacred and serious. It is sacred because marriage is established by God himself, a most serious commitment because it will bind you together for life in a relationship so close and intimate that it will profoundly influence your entire future. Not knowing all that is before you as husband and wife, you take each other for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, to have and to hold. It is a tribute to your faith in each other that you are both so willing and ready to pledge your honor and fidelity to such a solemn obligation. Henceforth, you belong entirely to each other from this day forward, one in mind, in spirit, and affection. Whatever you may sometimes have to sacrifice to preserve the dedication of common interests, do it gladly, generously, and within the deepest meaning of love. For this, by giving each other all that you have, you will receive everything you desire from your marriage. Living has its hopes and disappointments. It has its pleasures and problems. It has success and failure, joy and sorrow. Contradictions mingle in every life and are expected from time to time in your own future. But if true love, an unselfish spirit, a perfect sacrifice, guide your every thought and action, you can expect the most profound and earthly happiness that any man or woman may know in this life. I would like to do a little reading for you now, and this reading is called The Art of Marriage. The little things are the big things. It's never been too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not expecting the husband to wear a halo. Enough said about that, right? Or the wife to have wings of an angel. Strong possibilities there, strong possibilities. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for the things of the spirit. It's a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. This time I would like to offer up a wedding prayer for Doug and for Tara. Father in heaven, our hearts are filled with great happiness on this our wedding day. We come before the altar of love, pledging our hearts and our lives to each other. We pray that we may be ever true and loving to one another and avoid all pretense or envy. May we together meet the cares and problems of life bravely, and may our home be a place of love and harmony. Walk beside us, Father, we pray, through all our life together. Amen. And Doug, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health and forsaking all others? Be faithful to her so long as you both shall live. If so, answer, I do.
I do.
And Tara, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health and forsaking all others? Be faithful to him so long as you both shall live. If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Are those your final answers?
Final answer.
Excellent. We're very fortunate to have with us today a young man who's going to do a reading, and that's Jaya. Who's Jaya?
The Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him. So the Lord formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be his name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be a suitable partner for the man. So the Lord cast a deep sleep on the man, and sleep while he was asleep, he took one of his ribs and closed it up with flesh. The Lord God then built the woman with the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, this one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman. For out of her man, this one has been taken. That is why man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body.
Thank you so much. can face each other. Excellent. These are your wedding vows. Please repeat after me.
I, Doug.
I, Doug.
Take you, Tara.
Take you, Tara.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
I, Tara.
I, Tara.
Take you, Doug.
Take you, Doug.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or worse.
For richer for poorer.
For richer for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
Word perfect. Obviously, we can get you a nice ring out of this now in a minute, huh, Ben? And we come now to the lighting of the unity candle. You just make your way over there. The two outside candles have been lighted to represent your lives to this moment. They're two distinct lights, each capable of going its separate way. To bring joy and radiance into your home, there must be the merging of these two flames into one. From this time onwards, may your thoughts be for each other rather than for individual selves. May your plans be mutual, your joys and sorrows shared. And as you each take a candle, and together light the center one. You will extinguish your own candles. Thus having the center candle represent the union of your two lives into one flesh. As this center light cannot be divided, let not your lives be divided, but instead be the united testimony of a Christian home as Christ gives you light. I would like to do a little reading for you now. This is a reading from a book called The Prophet by Khalil Gibran. And the reading is on love. Love gives naught but itself and takes naught but from itself. Love possesses, nor would it be possessed, for love is sufficient unto love. When you love, you should not say, God is in my heart, but rather, I am in the heart of God. And think not you can direct the course of love. For love, if it finds you worthy, directs your course. Love has no other desire but to fulfill itself. But if you love and must needs have desires, let these be your desires. To melt and be like a running brook that sings its melody to the night. To know the pain of too much tenderness. To be wounded by your own understanding of love. And to bleed willingly and joyfully. To wake at dawn with a winged heart and give thanks for another day of loving. And to rest at the noon hour and meditate love's ecstasy. To return home at evening tide with gratitude. And then to sleep with a prayer for the beloved in your heart. And a song of praise upon your lips. Love never fails. Having this love in your hearts, you've chosen to seal your vows by the giving and the receiving of rings. Okay, you got to give the jewelry back, whether you like it or not. Third finger, Doug, left hand, and repeat after me.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vows.
As a symbol of my vows.
And with all that I am.
Sorry.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
That's all that I am and all that I have. That goes very deep. Third finger, Tara, left hand, repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vows.
As a symbol of my vows.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
A circle is a symbol of the sun and the earth and the universe, of wholeness and perfection and peace. The rings you give and receive this day are the symbols of the endless love into which you enter as husband and wife. Bless the Lord, these rings to be a sign of the vows with which this man and woman have bound themselves to each other. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. We're also very fortunate today to have Marianne with us, who's going to do a reading.
It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres.
Thank you so much.
And at this time, I would like to offer up a wedding prayer for Doug and for Tara. Eternal God, creator and preserver of life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon this man and this woman whom you make one flesh in holy matrimony. Grant that their wills be so knit together in your will, and that their spirits be so knit with your spirit, that each may grow in love and peace with you and with one another all the days of their lives. Give them grace when they hurt each other, to recognize and acknowledge their faults, and to seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Make their life together a sign of Christ's love for a sinful and broken world. Give them such fulfillment and mutual affection that they may reach out in love and concern for others. And grant that all married persons who have witnessed these vows may find their life strengthened and their loyalties confirmed through Jesus Christ. Amen. And we come now to the pronouncement of marriage. But just before I do, let me tell you once again what a great pleasure it is for me to be here to share this wonderful moment with you. I know how difficult it is when you're far away. So I am very, very appreciative of the fact that you trusted me from so far away to do your wedding for you. It means a lot to me, and I tried to do it justice and to make sure that when we met that we had something that we all liked. And I have to say that when I met you, it was just delightful. It was wonderful. And I know you've had a long day today and you got married again this morning, you get married now, so you're well and truly married now, that's for sure. Absolutely. But from my heart to yours, I'm 100% certain you're exactly where you should be today. And I want to wish you a lifetime of love, great happiness, and lots of great adventures. But thanks very much for sharing. Now that Doug and Tara have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, before us and before God as witness, they've shown their affection and trust by the giving and the receiving of rings and by joining hands. By the power invested in me, I pronounce that they are husband and wife. Therefore, where God has joined together, let no one separate. Amen. And Doug, you may kiss your beautiful wife, sir. Just stay there, stay there. Stay right there. Ready to rush out? You ready for that drink? We're going to bring our service to a conclusion now, and we're going to do that with an old Irish blessing. May you have warm words on a cold evening, a full moon on a dark night, and the road downhill all the way to your door. May you be poor in misfortune, rich in blessing. Slow to make enemies, quick to make friends. But rich or poor, quick or slow, may you know nothing but happiness from this day forward. Give me the first congratulations, Doug. Long, long life and happiness to you.
Thank you.
Super couple.
Thank you. I appreciate it very
beautiful
much.
Bride. Going to be a great wife, right?
I am.
Absolutely.
I am.
Don't forget your flowers there, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to hear thunderous applause, please, as we greet the new and wonderful Mr. and Mrs. Douglas and Tara Cunningham.